What's up, guys? Thanks for tuning in. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to remove an old radio and put in a new radio. This process can be used on your boat or your car. It's really simple, really straightforward. It's basic steps on how to get you going. So the kind of radio I'm using is a cheap little radio here I have. I had this laying around in my garage, so I didn't want to go buy another one. It's not a marine radio, so if you're worried about corrosion and that kind of stuff, or water, get yourself a marine radio. However, I'm going to put a splash guard on here, and it's going to be in an area that's going to be covered, so I'm not too worried about that for right now. And it's only $20, this radio, so I'm really not too worried about it getting damaged either. Alright, so first things first, we're going to remove it out of the package. Cool, basic stuff, not too much in here. So this is your wiring harness. You're going to want your wiring harness out of here, and just take the radio out of the case, the bag I mean, and the rest of it, just trash it. You can get the remote out of the box if you want, but for now we're not going to need that. Cool. So. Alright, so this is the wiring harness right here, which hooks up to the back of the radio here. So for right now, all we're going to use is these two cables right here, the red and yellow, and the black cable. Red and yellow, this is your ignition cable, is yellow. Red is your power cable, black is your negative cable. Also, this is a remote cable, not really sure what that's for. I think it's for like if you have a subwoofer or something like that hooked up. That's what that does. Turns on that or gives it a signal. I don't know. But for now, this is like a really basic video on how to get this going. So here's my old radio. And as you can see, I got all my wires hooked up here already. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut all my old wires off here and just transfer them. So I'm gonna cut all my old wires off here and just transfer them over to my new radio. So this right here is going to be my positive cable. And right here is my ground. Awesome. Okay. Alright guys, so once you disconnected your cables from your existing radio, you want to disconnect. You want to disconnect your audio cables. Just give them a good snip with your wire cutters. Boop. Good snip with your wire cutters. Shawam bam. Oh. Oh, oh. Okay, that's disconnected. So now you're going to put this aside because this is junk. You might want the antenna here because unfortunately the Walmart one didn't come with the antenna. So that's trash. Get all that away. So now we're going to take our new wire harness that fell on the floor over here. Going to hook it up to the back. Or not, hook it up. No, you're going to hook it up to the back. Okay. Get that in there nice and snug. So we're going to grab our wires that we just cut off the old one. Okay, now remember which one is your positive and which one's your negative. So for me, this is going to be my positive cable. So you're going to take your positive cable, you're going to connect it to the yellow and the red cable. Remember, it's the yellow and the red cable. Twist them all together. Okay. Let's give it a little trim so you can fit that gray cap that I used earlier. Or you can just take some electrical tape, wrap it all up. Should be good to go. So take your cap, if you have it, twist it all together, that secures that. Your next step is you're going to take your ground cable, make sure you strip this end, You're going to connect your ground cable. Take one of your little connectors. Throw it on there. And that's connected. Awesome. So if you hit the power button, your radio should turn on like so. As you can see, it says welcome. All the lights turn on. And that's that. Also, so remember now, the way we did it, we hooked up the yellow and red together. So that means that the radio will not turn off when you turn the key ignition. So remember, every time, if you don't want to drain your battery, hit the power button, turn it off. Sweet. All right, cool. So the next thing we're going to do is those radio cables that we connected earlier, which are on the floor. Okay, cool. Great. Sweet. All right. Okay, so if you read the top of your thing or inside your box, if you have a different kind of speaker, they all have the layout of where the orders of the speakers are, the cables are. And for this one, let's see, left front, it's going to be white and white and black. So white and white and black. So that's this and this. So you want to match up your striped one with your striped one, with your one on the, with the stripe, which is going to be your negative, and then your solid with your solid. Okay? One's going to be a positive cable, one's going to be a negative cable, so you always want to make sure you get that right. I'm going to be honest with you guys. I had a whole roll of electrical tape here earlier, and I just like spent 30 minutes looking for it and I couldn't find it. But I got some duct tape. And duct tape will do just fine. Hopefully. So we're going to take some duct tape and those speaker cables that we just connected, we're going to just duct tape them off. Secure them. Duct tape is like the tool in the military. You use this stuff for everything, so it'll be fine. Okay, so next we did the white and the white black. Now we're gonna do the other front speakers, which is the gray black. So again, you're gonna take the stripe side of your cable, and you're gonna hook it up to the stripe side. So that way, when we go hook everything up to the speakers, we know what's what. Like the easiest way to do everything here. Okay. Now remember guys, this is just a basic radio installation video. It may not be professional quality, but I promise you that this works. This works. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. You know, you can button things up better. You can use better quality equipment if you want, but this is like low budget. You know, I don't really have that much money, but, I try to do the best that I can with all the work that I do, and generally it comes out great. All right. So cool. So we're going to disconnect this cable here. And now we're going to head over to the dashboard. I'll show you the dashboard now. Okay. So what you want to do is feed the cables through here down towards where your battery is. Or if you have space like I do, you can feed the cables up through out through there and towards where your radio is going to be. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay, pull your cables through. Take your unit. Plug the cable in the back here. And then you're just going to guide the cables back in there. And slide the unit in place. Actually, I'm going to have to take this piece off, actually, because it looks like the existing harness, this cage thing, is already there, so it's not going to fit. Okay, so once you pull that off, or if you need it, keep it on. That's what locks it in there. You bend those things up, and it locks inside this your box there. Cool. So slide that in there. Push it in there nice and snug. Voila! Look at that. Perfect, right? Yeah. Cool. Okay. So now I'm going to hook this speaker up. So I got this old speaker here. And all I'm going to do is hook the positive side to the positive side, which is going to be the striped side, which is this side, and this side. So first I have to repair these wires. So we'll do that. So I'm going to just take this without like ruining it like that. Matter of fact, okay, I know what I'm going to do. Wish I had a paper towel. So I'm going to need this piece to connect the new wire there, and I'll just remove this piece and connect it with, let's see if this one fits over there. Okay, it's a little big, so maybe they're both going to be the red. Normally one side's wider than the other, though. No, that's the wrong, that's the male connector. Okay, clip. Shwing bam. Okay, great. So these are the two pieces you're going to want to need to connect to your speaker. They'll be in that kit if you buy it at Walmart, or you could just get it at any auto parts store, or really anywhere has it. Anywhere that sells electrical stuff. So you're going to come over to the speaker cable. Okay, you're going to strip the cables with your wire stripper. Strip the cables. Really easy stuff, really easy to do. Like I said, this is real basic, real easy stuff to do, man. So, anybody can pretty much do this. You don't have to go spend $400 or $500 to have some guy charge you to do your radio installation. And so these just clamp on here. So you just slide this on in there. Gotta kind of make them skinny enough to fit. Clamp it down. Make sure they're nice and snug. So next thing you want to do is you want to connect your positive side. So we said that the positive side is going to be the solid, so we're going to put the solid there. And the negative side there. So they're kind of loose, so I'm just going to snug it, like tighten it down a little bit. Squeeze, give it a good little squeeze. Check it. Place it back there. Take my screws from earlier. that's pretty much how I do it. It's real basic. I'm not a professional, but got it done. Like and subscribe. If you have any comments, questions, or anything like that, send me a message or comment on the video below, and I'll get back to you.